So, hello everyone, my name is Simon Schramm. I'm professor here at the University of Applied Science in the Department of Electrical Energy, and I'm professor for renewable energies. And today I want to talk about the topic, where does the electrical energy comes from? Does it come from the socket, or where does it come from? And for that I have prepared just a single slide, and I want to talk through this slide with you together. And let's start on the right side, where we have our house. That's where we live in. And here in the house we have a socket, and in this socket we can plug in our electric loads. Electric loads like a television, a washing machine, light bulb, and whatever. And the question is, where does the energy that is consumed by the light bulb or the other devices comes from? And for that we need to understand a first physical principle. The energy that is consumed by our load, by our light bulb, needs to be provided at the time where we consume it. So meaning, when you switch on your load, your light bulb for example, it needs to be provided at this instant of time. And there is no inherent storage in the electrical system. This is what we want to talk about now. And so in the electric system there is no inherent storage capability, so the power or the electricity that is consumed at the time needs to be produced at this time. And if we now look around in our house, we might see other components connected to the electric system, the same as our socket is. For example, we have a local power generation on the top with the green photovoltaic modules. This local power generation can produce electricity, and in case the electricity is produced at the time where we consume electricity, for example, while we switched on our loads, then part of the electricity from the photovoltaics will be used directly in our house, in our local energy system. In case we are not turning on any loads, the power that is produced by the photovoltaics will flow to some other loads, either in our house, if there is no other load connected or consuming, it will flow in direction Hausanschluss, point of common coupling. This is where the grid basically starts. So the blue lines in our house are our local electrical system, and then we will follow in with time now within this series, also in direction to the grid. So we have already, as mentioned, we have local power generation, we have maybe also other loads like an electric car, and there is another orange marked device which is called a flexibility. In this case it's a battery, and the battery can also be used to consume electricity or to provide electricity. The battery itself does nothing. The battery needs commands from some control system in order to tell, do I need to charge or do I need to discharge? And this is also indicated here in these blue boxes, intelligent measurement device. So some measurement device measuring voltage, power at our point of common coupling, and also control boxes that control devices like the battery or try to optimize the loads together with our local power generation. So if you now want to understand where does the electricity come from, we have already the first answers. If we have local power generation or we have flexibilities like the battery, these both can provide part of the energy that is consumed by our loads, depending on the time, if the power is generated at the time where the loads consume. If not, we can still turn on the lights and they still work. Why? Because there are other energy producers, power generation units outside of our house. So now if we leave our house through the point of common coupling towards the grid, then we will see first along the cable we will be connected to some distribution cable. The distribution cable is maybe thicker than the cable that connects my house to the distribution system. And why is it thicker? it can carry, it is built out of more copper, so the cross section of the cable is thicker in order to carry more current. Why is current so important? The power that we consume, the power that our loads consume, is the voltage times the current. And the voltage in our distribution feeder that we are now talking on, like our house, is at a fixed voltage level of around 230 volts if we look at a single phase load, or at 400 volts if we have a three phase load. And so the voltage is fixed. If we want to increase the power, like we want to double the light bulb size, then we need to increase the current. And more current requires larger cross section of our cable. On this low voltage cable, there are also other customers connected, like commercial customers, charging stations, and of course, many more households. And if we continue following the cable of our low voltage system, then we will end up at some point at a transformer. So the symbol with the two rings is a transformer. The main task of the transformer is to raise the voltage, to push the voltage to a higher voltage level, for example, to 20 kilovolts. Then we reach the medium voltage distribution grid, 20 kilovolts. Why is 20 kilovolts? It is higher than the 230, 400 volts low voltage. And if we want to transfer more power, then this is the next step. 20 kilovolts is, for example, 50 times the 400 volts of our low voltage system. So if we assume same currents in the medium voltage system, we can transfer 50 times the power than with the same current in the low voltage grid. So higher voltage allows us higher power to be transferred, larger loads to be connected, as it's shown here, fast charging stations, larger batteries, wind turbines, smaller power plants, hydrogen production sites. All those systems can be connected to the medium voltage side, and of course many low voltage feeders like our house and the cables that connect our house to the medium voltage side. If you now continue following the medium voltage, and there is also high voltage at up to 110 kilovolts still belonging to the distribution system. If we then follow again this medium voltage or high voltage side towards the next transformer, then we leave the distribution system. We raise again the voltage to even higher voltages, to very high voltage, like 220 kilovolts or 400 kilovolts. And this is then called the transmission system. The reason for getting even higher with the voltage is again to transmit higher power levels. And there's another thing, if you want to transfer power over long distances, then you want to do that with comparable low losses. So, and losses directly correspond to currents that you transfer. So reducing current allows transfer power with less losses. And so the transmission system operates at very high voltages to operate at reasonable currents to allow transmit of power at low losses, at comparable low losses. And you see in the very high voltage transmission system, large power plants, conventional ones burning fossil fuel, also large renewable power plants like wind farms. There is HGÜ, in English HVDC, high voltage transmission systems that can transmit power over very long distances. And there is a European symbol, meaning the transmission system is not stopping at our borders in Germany. We have an interconnection system in Europe in the transmission area, in the very high voltage range. In all these voltage levels, we have power plants connected. And coming back to the initial question, where does electrical energy come from? It depends. This is always a question. It depends when you consume it and when the others produce it. So the easiest answer is it comes from your local power generation in case you're producing sufficient energy for your loads. but it can also come from some commercial customer visits PV, from wind plants or from somewhere else in Europe, dependent on where is the electricity produced and where is the load consumed and at which time. So this was basically the story about where does electrical energy comes from and how is the structure, the electrical structure behind my socket. Thank you for your attention.